Hey guys, you are most welcome again on my YouTube channel, and today we are going to talk about That Long Silence, which got published in 1988, birth year of mine, Kaushik. And this is an expression of agony of housewives. This work is written by Shashi Deshpande, a famous Indian writings in English writer. And the story revolves around Jaya, an educated young woman, lives with her husband Mohan and two children, Rahul and Rati. So here are the main characters, Mohan, Jaya, Rahul and Rati.
Guys, thank you so much for your visit to our family. We need your support and love. Please press subscribe button and bell icon. It's totally free. Good luck for your exams. Now enjoy.
Four characters we have here. And Jaya is a sufferer of gender differentiation and patriarchy. After wedding, she becomes speechless in order to be a good cultural wife. This is the story. Let's go ahead. The novel questions the tradition-bound Indian society that treats women unkindly. What do you think? Do we really treat women unkind? That Long Silence is Deshpande's perspective on marital fiction. My aim is to highlight how women are divided between traditional values of the society and her individuality. This video will analyze how the patriarchal domination and gender differentiation exists within the family. Like Shashi Deshpande want to talk about this. So in this video, we are going to talk about we can say gender differentiation. And for exam purpose, we need to remember the story, what happens in the story, and who are the main characters, who are the small characters in this work, and what are the keywords. So whenever we are going to talk about a work, we need to know the keywords. If you don't know the keywords, how can I express myself? Is work mein aap logon ke keywords jo hain wo gender differentiation hai, patriarchal society hai, desolation hai, silence hai, or we can say individuality hai. And this happens in Indian society ki agar aap educated girl bhi hain aur aap agar kisi dusri family mein jab shaadi hone ke baad jaate hain, so you need to keep silence. You don't have that much freedom to speak about your desires. That's the thing, that's the important theme of the work. And let's talk about this work. As Alice Walker says, no person in your friend who demands your silence or denies your right to grow. Like Alice Walker is saying ki, if you really want to grow, you need to speak. Okay, nobody is saying this to you that you need to be silent. Okay, in Western countries, if we say, women give more preferences to liberalism and believe in rejecting the family structure, but Indian women have to struggle with male as well as female members of their families for their identity. And this happens. We cannot deny this fact. Okay, Shashi Deshpande's novel expresses her thought on the position of Indian women. So if you'll go through this work, you will you will have the position of Indian women. Like you cannot say no even if you are right. Okay, as a feminist view, even if you are right, you cannot say no. Like in this story mein hota kya hai ki jo Jaya hai uska husband hai Mohan, aur wo ek clerk hai, aur wo bribe leta hai, logo se ghus leta hai, paise leta hai. But what happens, she doesn't want this. Okay, she wanted to stop all this, but she never said no to him. Why? Because he was giving simply a simple reason to her that I am taking bribe because of you, Jaya and Rahul and Rati. Means for you I am taking bribe. And after listening to this reason, she kept her mouth closed. Okay, this is the story. Okay, That Long Silence is a woman's journey from her state of desolation to her self-recognition that she is suffering due to silence. She is keeping her silence. Now, what are the themes of the work? We can say major themes. Gender inequality, marital conflict, male domination, husband's ill-treatment towards their wives and identity crisis of women means they cannot find the identity, they cannot voice, they cannot voice their desires. Okay, Jaya is the wife of Mohan. He is materialistic and a male chauvinist. Mohan is typically a workaholic person. He is workaholic person. Okay, his career is more important than his family. He is ambitious, fond of luxury and position in society, cares for money and material objects. Mohan wants to consider himself as the sole runner and the head of family. He wants himself as the head of family. So it is shown in the work that he does not care about Jaya's feelings and takes for granted. He imposed his thoughts on Jaya and forces her not to write something which would affect their relationship because she is a reporter too. Okay, and there is a thought that in Indian society, hum log yehi kehte hain ki ek juye se bandhe hue rehte hain, husband and wife. Juye means yokes. Okay, bullocks yoked. So two bullocks yoked together. This is okay. She finds her marriage as two bullocks yoked together means do bell aapas mein bandhe gaye hain. And her frustration is shown her when she says, "Ever since I got married," she talks about her marriage. Okay, in these lines, you should listen to very carefully. This will make your thought clear about her work and her situation about and what she thinks about her marriage. "Ever since I got married, I had done nothing but waiting for Mohan to come home, waiting for the children to be born, for them to start school, waiting for them to come home, and waiting for the milk, the servant, the lunch, carrier man." So these lines and what she is, this is kind of soliloquy and monologue. You can say monologue. Okay, monologue. In this monologue, she tells she got married, she had done nothing, waiting for Mohan to come home. And these are the works for a typical housewife. Even she is educated. She has to do this in Indian society. She goes into deep introspection of her life, conflicts with her husband, suffocation in their 17 years old marriage, dissatisfaction in her children, Rahul and Rati, in her state of desolation. Jaya decides to write down her story. In this process, she explores her self-existence. So while she is writing this story of her own, she wants an identity. She is introspecting herself. She is exploring her self-existence. So if you are listening to this story, this is all about her self, exploring her self-existence. And let's talk about the beginning of silence, when she started her silence. Jaya's name was converted to Suhasini. Her name was converted to Suhasini. What Suhasini means, the name Suhasini means a soft, smiling, placid, motherly woman. Ki unka jo naam change kiya gaya tha, aur wahan par she didn't want this, but because of Mohan, her husband, she tells that, "Yes, let's change my name." Okay, so you can see here, this was the first thing they did. Okay, name is the identity of every human being, isn't it? No one has a right to tell that I don't like your name and I will call you by other name. But just after her marriage, she loses her identity because she gets changed her name. And Jaya wrote some stories and won first prize. These stories also gets published in a magazine, and she is getting recognition as a writer. When Mohan, Jaya's husband, expresses his wrath on her theme, she wrote a story about a man who cannot connect to his wife except through her body. Listen to this. Okay, this was the story, and here again the same thing means there was a suppression, isn't it? She was getting suppressed by Mohan. She was writing something, he didn't like it, and she has to change it. This is the story. Okay, Mohan thinks that a particular man in the story is himself. He thinks that he himself is there, the man. Okay, and I think if he was doing these things to her, definitely he was the same man, and she was just writing. Okay, and Mohan's insensitivity. Write down this word, Mohan's insensitivity. Jaya gets attached to Kamath, a widower, and her neighbor in Dada. Kamath lives alone in the home. He does not feel awkward while cooking himself because he does not think that cooking is a woman's business. Now, see here. Next, so we have got some characters like Jaya, Mohan, Rati, Rahul, and now Kamath. Okay, yeah, Kamath. Kamath is the another person in some work, in some exams it can be asked. Okay, spare me your complexes. Women are the victims theory of yours. Take yourself seriously. And don't sulk behind a false name and work if you want others to take you seriously. So these were the words by Kamath, and she was really impressed by his thought because he was a man who was cooking for himself, and he doesn't think that this is work of a woman. I hope you liked the story till now.